Hi and welcome. Today we'll be learning how to model a 3D character like this. I picked up this blueprint on the internet, Sonic Bloom. I'm sure you'll be able to locate it, but if you can't, just give me a shout. So yeah, let's get started. We're first gonna do our basic views, so we're just gonna drag that, make a new, edit, paste, slide it over, copy, paste, and last one, copy, paste. So we don't need that for now. Then just save these. Sonic site profile, and we'll save it as a JPEG. Sonic back. And Sonic front. Okay, we can close this now, we don't need it. Okay, so now what we want to do is set up our images. What I normally do is go to viewport, background, custom image, configure, locate it, match bitmap, and lock zoom pan. So the reason why I do this is just to get the right size. We're going to drag out a plane and match it up to that blueprint. We're gonna take the line segs off. I disable grids. I don't really use the grids for this. So we've got our box there. I noticed in 3D Max 2013 there were a lot of changes that they did, so we're just going to fix those. Right click onto the model and go to object properties, and then I've noticed in 3D Max 2013 they've changed the system here, and instead of, we just need to change that by object instead of by layer. They've put all the objects into a layer instead of by object. So we've got that. We can take off show frozen in gray, and that's fine. Then hit M key for your material panel and get a standard material. Then go to diffuse mode and look for checker. I don't use bitmap because for some reason it doesn't display your model properly. So I prefer to just use checker and then bitmap. Locate your sonic character, and we'll start with the front, show viewport in map. And now another problem is to take off this real world map size option here, and then your model should display properly. And what we want to do is we want to do a profile for the side. So make sure your angle snap toggle is on. Select your plane and rotate it to the side. Change the instance to copy and hit OK. So now we're just gonna clone this. It's a good idea to name your materials, so we'll just say front, duplicate it over and say side, and then go back in there and change it to the side profile. Same thing for the back. And locate the back. Okay, we've got all those set up now. So now we need to go to our perspective. Drag and drop the side on. That's fine. We can maybe center this so we line up our model, and then afterwards we put it back. That's fine. Doesn't need to be 100%. Put that there, that there. And for the back, we won't do the back right now. If we need the back for a later purpose for modeling the back of the head, then we'll turn the back on. But for now, that's fine. Just go to back to our viewports now, viewport background, and remove that. You don't need that anymore, and then put smooth highlights onto the side and front profile. That's all fine. We can take show goods off there, and then we just want to select both objects, object properties, and freeze, so that it doesn't move around. Okay, so now we've got our blueprint set up, and I think I'll leave it there. And next part, we can start modeling the character.